Good morning.
Okay, all right, I just want to...
Let us begin and stand. We're singing hymn number 278, One Day. Let us stand. Continue to sing hymn number 94, Joy Will Come in the Morning. I believe this is a very singable song. I'm not sure how familiar I am with it. We'll see. And you can make up for my deficit, please.
Information back there, and the Pittsburgh Bible Church Photo Album Project, looking for photo donations. So if y'all have any photos from around the church or you know, anything through the years, if you could bring them in, we're going to put them in the album. And we have some Olympian awards. Yes, I have some other things to share. Have a couple updates. Tiffany Robinson. Tiffany's PET scan showed an improvement in every area and no new spreading of the cancer. So that is very good news for Tiffany. I think I shared last week that they had gone away on vacation, so she was able to travel some. Hadn't, you know, heard how everything went or anything, but didn't hear if there was any problems. So that's good. They were able to travel. No new spreading cancer. Very good news. That's a praise. They'll continue with treatments and consult with Johns Hopkins and the Cancer Center in Boston. So that's what they'll be up to. So just continue to pray. Dawn, your brother, also is doing well. Okay, so we've been praying for Dawn's brother, Lynn. He had cancer surgery March 13th, and then he had an infection, and all that cleared up, and the cancer responded to the treatment. So just continue to keep Lynn in your prayers. Alan Wallach goes back to the surgical group in York this week. They're hoping they can leave the wound back off. He still has a wound in his chest, and that infection and all that is starting to clear up. So just keep Alan in your prayers for all that. Please be in prayer for, continue to pray for Pastor Paul as he finished up his pastoral studies and looking for God's calling. So continue to pray for him. I have an update here. Well, one thing, please be in prayer for Benny. Benny continues to have some health issues. So pray for Benny that he feels better. Continue to keep him in your prayers. And I got an update for Miss Shirley and Mr. Earl Shiflett. Mr. Earl and Miss Shirley have been with us here several times. He came in the one time, you know, and asked us to pray about his eyesight. Continue to pray about that. But Mr. Earl, who's 90 now, has fallen twice recently. He hasn't, you know, gotten hurt real bad, just bruises, but he has fallen twice. So be in prayer for him for that. Miss Shirley, who's 88, she has two leaky heart valves, and she has an appointment this Tuesday for surgery options. So be in prayer for Miss Shirley Shiflett. They're going to be staying with their daughter in Westminster because of the surgery and all that sort of thing. They'll be staying with their daughter. After that, they'll be moving to Hartford County. They want to thank all of us at Pittsburgh for prayers and our concern. So just continue to keep them in our prayers that there'll be healing there for them. I asked you last week to pray for Johnny as he goes down to North Carolina. He got there yesterday. He starts his internship with Hendrick. They called last week on Thursday, I think it was, and gave him two VIP tickets to the NASCAR race. So, yeah, in the VIP suite and all that. It's all weekend long, and the reason I'm bringing that up is to continue to pray for him for his internship, but I probably will be there next week because he wants me to go to the race with him on Saturday. So,
the problem could do no less.
Yeah, that's right. So, we'll probably be here next week. So, just want to let everybody know that. So, I'll have to force myself to go to the NASCAR race. Any other?
Yeah, we have flowers out in the vestibule, a belated Mother's Day. We weren't here for Mother's Day, so the ladies can take one of those.
Okay.
And also a prayer request. Our grandson, Drew, who's 21, just got married in January. He's enlisted in the Army, and he's in boot camp right now.
Okay.
And actually, praise the Lord, he had, through his wife, found out he's enjoying it.
Oh. Enjoying boot camp. Okay.
Just pray for him, you know. This is really weird. His name is Andrew Martz. Drew Martz. His roommate, who believe it, from Ohio. Martz. His name is Martz.
Really?
Or they don't think they, you know, probably down the road somewhere.
Yeah, somewhere they were probably related, but not yet.
Yeah, so that's kind of an answer. it's hard. I mean, he just got married.
Right.
In January. And, so just pray for Drew. And Drew came in, goes for special training after he graduated from boot camp in the last part of June. And he goes to Texas.
Cybersecurity.
So he's going to specialize in cybersecurity.
Okay. So be in prayer for
Drew. Drew Marks.
Yep. Drew Marks, Pat Sam and Jackie's grandson. He's got married in January. He's in boot camp now. So just be in prayer for him. Something else came to mind. I'm going that quick. Oh, the flowers. So in the back, if you didn't hear, there's flowers in the back of the late Mother's Day present to the mothers that Pastor Sam and Miss Jackie brought. So make sure that you get them. Anything else that I guess? Any other announcements or prayer?
For the Memorial Day thing, just confirming there's no sign-up sheet. You're just bringing whatever you want to bring. We're not making this fancy.
Is that correct?
Yep.
Okay. Yes, that's correct.
Yes, I'm in for overly planning. All right, so we've been working with our Olympians for a while, and we realized that we've been negligent in handing out certificates for the levels they've achieved. So we're going to give out some bronze level certificates for today. In order to get achieve bronze level, depending on the age group, you have to memorize so many verses, you have to do some Christian service, acts of Christian service, and you have to do some book reports, some of which we did together, and sometimes they do it on their own. So I need Olivia Myers to come up here. You can't leave until I tell you. Owen. And Reagan. Where's Reagan? Okay, and Josh.
Whisper and die.
Proud look. why would Proud look? What was the first sin of Satan himself? That idea that he could replace God. That pride. Pride is definitely number one. A lying tongue. God has nothing to do with untruth. He is 100% truth. Hands that shed innocent blood. Didn't that start already with Cain and Abel? Hearts that devise imaginations. In other words, when we get ahead of ourselves and have thoughts of that are out of our jurisdiction, when we take upon ourselves things that were not in the God's design for us. Feet, swift and running to mischief. Notice how many parts of the body here are in the metaphor. We have the hands, the heart, and now the feet. The feet that are quick to find the wrong place to be. False witness that speaks lies. A false witness speaking lies. Need we mention Michael Cohen? we're not supposed to do politics here. Okay. Sows discord among brethren. God hates that when you use your opportunities to poke at the push buttons and make the worst come out. God does not tolerate that. It's in the top seven here. Okay, and 1 John 2:15 reminds us, love not the world, neither the things in the world. If you love the world, the love of the Father is not in you. That is the metric that you can use. How can you know whether you're a right on? Is the love of the Father in you.
Show your love to the Lord and focus on Him and some verses.
Okay. All right, this is how we're going to do it. He's handing it off to me. Okay. 1 John 4:19 tells us, we love Him. Why? Because He first loved us. Okay, and that love, I believe your notes say here, like a parent to a child. Okay. Mark 12, verse 30. Love the Lord thy God with all thy soul, all thy mind, and all thy strength. Do we check that out, that we really love Him all the way?
Then going back to the previous verse, how do we keep ourselves in God's love? First of all, building up yourselves on your most holy faith. And that means building on the foundation. When you see someone with a backhoe digging a foundation, you expect eventually a building, right? You just pour cement. You do it because foundation. This church has a physical foundation somewhere. Not at the cemetery. It's under the church here. So let's talk about who is our foundation. 1 Corinthians 3.
No other foundation. Other foundation can no person lay than that is laid, which is Jesus Christ. Now, if any person build upon this foundation, and then it mentions the different materials you can use, you need to have the genuine materials.
One point here, where that word is in Greek language, it means since. It means God expecting somebody to build. You got a builder, he pours the concrete, he comes back in 6 months? I don't think so. Hey, when you're going to start laying block? Jesus in our foundation, He says, do some building on it. And in Ephesians tells us more.
Built on the foundation of apostles and prophets, Jesus Christ Himself is the chief cornerstone. The whole building fitly framed together grows into a holy temple in the Lord.
You know, it says most holy. We just had the song. That song that they sang. I've got to give another secret. I'm hearing problems, and I mentioned it to my audiologist. She's giving my wife a microphone on her, and what she says whispers, I hear it in my ears. So if you hear me take this out, so she's coaching me some of it you all sang, fit in very well. But also the faith. Something about faith. Faith is firm persuasion built upon a report. Romans 10:17.
Faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God.
Jude verse 3. In the first, the whole book of Jude is defending the faith. Now, my point is this. Between Thurlock and here, my wife and I passed a lot of churches. I don't have any comment about those churches. My comment is, I walk with the Lord. So, we can be so worried about all the problems of the world, we don't keep our hearts right with the Lord. Now, the second thing we do is praying in the Holy Spirit. We have an invitation to prayer.
Hebrews 4:16 reminds us, let us come boldly to the throne of grace and obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need. You should have that one memorized.
I've been doing that all week long. Lord, what's going on? And so, we're invited to come. God wants us to talk to Him. Parents, don't you want your children to talk to you? So there's an invitation. There's also a priority in prayer.
Acts 6, verse 4. We will give ourselves continually to prayer and to the ministry of the word, as the apostles speak.
And then 1 Thessalonians 5:17.
Pray without ceasing.
So priority in prayer. Something else I want to mention. My wife and I read through the Bible a year. Right now, the day I'm so glad we finished the book of Job. I'm serious. Every time, every year, I read through Job, something happens. One time I ran the car in front of the garage and busted front. Things have happened. The computer was wrong when I'm reading Job. My comment is this. I'm not Job, but Satan hasn't changed. And so I'm looking tomorrow morning, Psalm 1. Maybe my voice will come. So the intensity of prayer.
James reminds us the effectual, fervent prayer of the righteous man avails much.
When you think about Job, remember on Mount Carmel? The fire of God came down, consumed. He told the king, "Hey, king, get home. It's going to rain." Hadn't rained for 3.5 years. So you think about a guy praying, Lord, if you don't send rain, I'll be dead. That's kind of like me. I pray all week, Lord, I hope this Lord doesn't have a disaster. But what's happening to me? How good we're doing? Guess what would happen if we didn't plan this? That's when God did. He makes no mistakes. Now, the third way we keep in the love of God is looking for the mercy of the Lord Jesus Christ. The word look has the idea of lean out and look forward, waiting for it. We're anticipating and looking forward to God's mercy, God's attitude. Now, there's three areas: mercy, God, and salvation.
Ephesians 2, verse 4, but God, who is rich in mercy, for his great love wherewith he loved us.
And it talks about salvation. Aren't you glad God gives us mercy? I was a newspaper reporter, beside me a farmer. So I covered court. I never heard a defendant say, give me the book. Give it to me. What are they asking for? Judge, could you give me mercy? But God said, Judge, could you give me mercy? A wife, two children. He said, did you have a wife and two children? You did this? 6 months instead of 12. So we want God's salvation. I don't deserve salvation, but God has given us his mercy. We have some verses about that.
Titus 3, verse 5, not by works of righteousness which we have done, but his mercy, he saved us. I believe you have a note here on the button.
That means a
Jude 22, in the same passage, the following verse there, and of some have compassion, making a difference.
It's interesting, in the book of Jude, he talks about these wicked men and what they're going to do, and aren't we irritated by false teaching, all the cults? I'm not a Catholic, but the guy that gave the speech at a Catholic school about a Catholic family is an uncle. But we're talking here about people who have been influenced, unlike false leaders, but they're influencing people and don't know any better. I went to a Catholic one time, almost said to the Lord, I said, you want to accept Jesus? He said, you have to talk to my priest. So we're talking about reaching people with compassion. You can win people to the Lord by love rather than hammering them. I know where they're going, but if you hammer on them, they're not going to respond. So we need compassion. He that goes forth and weeps, earns preciously, will come again with rejoicing. I've often thought, if you put up all our tears in a container about lost souls, how big a container would we need? I don't cry much about loss. We should. We should have compassion on them. To the Lord. And the final use of mercy.
Mercy and the rapture of the church here. We're looking at Titus 2, verse 13. Looking into that blessed hope, the glorious appearing of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Again, Hank wouldn't know. That's all in capitals, because it's the same word. So poor Hank was trying to read my notes to myself. But thank the Lord. Looking for the Lord to come. I'm afraid it's going more. Those bitches can go somewhere else. If you want to come this morning, we're out here. So we're looking for the coming of the Lord, and we want to keep in God's love. My wife and I appreciate you folks. You are so tolerant, but at least now you have a visible hearing prayer request for my wife and me that God will use us for His glory. Thank you for your prayer.
I'm just glad to read that verse once more in Jude so that we pull it all together. But you, beloved, building yourselves up on your most holy faith, praying in the Holy Spirit, keep yourselves in the love of God, looking for the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ into eternal life. What's going to keep us on the genuine track is that we keep ourselves in the love of God. And that keep there, that wasn't an A-worth imperative. No particular time duration implied there. An imperative is not a suggestion. That is something active that we must do. We must choose to be kept in the love of God. That's what's going to mark us different in the world. That's what's going to keep us seeking the right doctrine. And our hope has to be focused on the right direction. I believe Satan and anyone else are falling as angels that fell when they stop looking at God and stop being part of His great love, then all sorts of bad things happen. Heavenly Father, we thank you how you keep us and you enable us with your Holy Spirit to be genuine followers of Christ, genuine sons and daughters and joint heirs with Jesus. And you equip us with the ability to discern and to say no to the desires of the flesh, and to say yes to the leading of the Holy Spirit, to do things that are beyond comprehension, to have a life that is meaningful beyond anything that we could have imagined. We thank you, Lord, how you are working and choosing to make us your very own, and you're carving out a holy priesthood, a wonderful, peculiar generation. We ask, Lord, that you hear our individual prayers as we look to you even now, and as we come to you and remember that we fall so far short. Our genuineness of faith doesn't always look so genuine, Lord, but we want to be people of faith, people that do not depend on ourselves to create this building and that we have not used wood, hay, and stubble, things that won't last, that will just burn up with, when Jesus inspects our building with the fire of his eyes. We want to be made of the genuine thing, something that will be glorious to behold, a tribute to who you are working in us. We ask, Lord, to bless us in the hearing that we have had this morning, and in the working out of our salvation with fear and trembling. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you. Now, while I'm up here, I want to take advantage of something. You have all prayed for our Christian school ministry, and we've been through a lot of ups and downs, and this property that we bought in 2020, that's just 4 years ago, and the building that we have started to renovate, but you know, we ran short on money. We are right now at the cusp of something wonderful. God is working. I want to explain it this way. Things that look like a negative are turning out to be a positive. One of the churches that works with us for Freedom, under the umbrella of Freedom Valley Worship Center, we're renters there, but we couldn't do our major programs and special events there, so Intersection Church was providing that space for us. Well, they had an issue with their ceiling beginning to collapse, and they had to cancel all programs there suddenly this spring. That sounds bad, like a negative. They're hassling with insurance to get that all fixed and so forth. So, we had to relocate. So, Liberty Chapel in Fairfield, Pennsylvania, opened their doors, allowed us to have a sports banquet, a spring banquet, and a YWAM conference there, and they wouldn't charge us for that. They just were gracious to us. It turns out that one of the leaders there was a former student of my wife back in second grade. You know, God is repaying. Well, that's not enough. Life Discovery Church opens their door and said we could do our baccalaureate service tonight there. Bethel Church opened up their door and said we'll do a spring production there, and they want to talk to us about making their gym available for a volleyball program.
First practice on Thursday.
Yes. And Harvest Chapel in Abbottstown says you can do graduation in our facilities. All of a sudden, five different churches are opening their doors and partnering with us. You think God's moving?
Yes.
And what's coming out of this, people are realizing, yes, they all have their different flavors and their different responsibilities, but we're one body of Christ. And this ministry, Freedom Christian School, belongs to the Lord, and it's his ministry. On top of that, our PE teacher, who volunteers wonderfully, he's a plumber and other things, but he does PE on Tuesday for us. He had a contact, and it's possible within the next week or so that an $800,000 loan will be made to us. People usually want a loan for nonprofits, but an $800,000 loan in such a way that we could make the payment $4,000 per month. And possibly within 4 months be within our structure. Is that God? Is that God?
Mm-hmm.
We need this so desperately. And I just want to tell you that the genuine thing that we've been talking about here, being genuine Christians, being representatives of the love of God, it is the Holy Spirit that works. And our prayers are heard, and God is real. And he's doing miracles where we can't do a thing, okay? It's way beyond us. And so I just want to throw that in. Okay, we're going to close with Blessed Assurance, if I have a handful.
Oh.
So let us stand and sing Blessed Assurance, Jesus is Mine, 463.
Jesus is mine, oh, what a glorious day, so glory in the night.
has stood among us, and you allowed your word to go forth, and we have freely heard. Now we pray, Lord, that we freely believe, and we live in the faith, look to the mercy of your return. And in the meantime, Lord, help us to keep ourselves in the love of God. We ask this by your grace and mercy. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
If I could have everybody's attention for a second before you go, it's my turn to screen off so I can go.
How do you push the forward button?
Oh, can you put it back up there? Thank you. I wanted to show everybody something, if this works. Also, I wanted to mention something I forgot to mention for prayer. Art, across the street, he's had some, Eric, he had a procedure done or something, I think.
Yes, sir.
And he's having some problems after that. It was some sort of heart procedure we just found out shortly ago. So please be in prayer for Art across the street. I don't know if it's going to work or not. If it doesn't, I'll show you next week. So far, it's not working. Yeah, we're getting closer. All right, well, we're going to, I don't know how to make it bigger on the screen, but this is Micah and Nikki Mizich's daughter. Micah's family came here for many years. But they put this on Facebook, and this is her daughter. I think she's 2 years old. Let me see if I can get the audio to work. I apologize. I didn't try this before church. Oh, okay. Getting closer. I had to. There we go.
The fruits of the Spirit.
The fruits of the Spirit.
Okay, so put on in this. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and gentleness, and then the stamp was gonna
draw.